on the road looking for a win against an Eastern Conference rival. The Miami Heat are ready to get this thing started. This is 2K Sports bringing you the NBA. I'm Kevin Harlan calling the action with my broadcast partners Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. A look now at the starting lineup brought to you by State Farm. And guys, what are we going to be looking for in this one from Rajon Rondo?
Well, he's one of the shiftiest players in the NBA, Kevin. The speed, the athleticism, the quick handle. So he's always catching defenses off guard. You see him really kind of going one way, getting the defense to lean, and then quick crossover, and all of a sudden he's at the rim.
Well, along those lines, he uses his speed in other situations too, Steve. I mean, he'll be the first one to run down a long rebound or a loose ball. And because of that, his rebound totals really add up. You add in how good he is at finding the open man, real deal Rondo, I call him.
You look at the Celtics. They return victorious from an undefeated road trip back to the loving embrace of their hometown faithful.
You know, right now for the Celtics, they performed at a level well below what I thought they were capable of. I mean, I expected a much, much better showing out of them.
You're not the only one who thought that, Clark. I mean, even if they weren't going to be an elite team, I think most people felt they would at least be competitive and solid, but they are really struggling.
Well, it was the Boston Celtics winning their last game against the Hawks in Atlanta.
Well, watching that game, Kevin, you couldn't help but think it was going to be their night, as well as everybody on the team was shooting the ball.
No question about it, Steve. I mean, you're not going to lose too many games where you have multiple players getting locked in like they were.
We're on the clock. Here's Bass, and hits it. Unbelievable. Bass has got himself going there, his first points of the game on the deep ball. All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
Kevin, I briefly spoke with Doc Rivers. This is their second time facing the defending NBA champs after losing their first meeting. Coach told me, we're going to try and change things up a bit, maybe slow the game up some more. We can't have LeBron and Wade just running out in transition as often as they please. It's clear their focus is defensive transition, guys.
Thanks, Doris. Here's Bradley after the Heat pick up two from about 16, and it's Haslam with the rebound. Just about 2 minutes into the game, first quarter of basketball. LeBron with it. Now Pierce defending. The quick look no good that time. The Celtics have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today.
And I thought the key factor was the contribution from the bench.
So true. I mean, a few of those guys came into the game and instantly sparked their offense, and you love to see that from the second unit.
You know, you look at Rajon Rondo, and the physical stature is not imposing. He's only 6 feet tall, but he's got a 6'9 wingspan and huge hands, so he ends up playing much bigger than you'd expect, and really a dominant player at that point guard position.
Dishes it to Bass. Harrington's there, and Bass kicks to Garnett. There's the pass to Bradley. Outside, Pierce. Over LeBron, and another basket for Boston. And Clark, when you talk about having big hands, you know, the ability to control the ball, how big is that for an NBA player, would you say?
Well, it's a nice asset, but it's not as important as good hands, and his are big and good, so he's got the double whammy there. But having large hands for a guy his size certainly helps him pass the ball, handle it, and retrieve rebounds, too.
And the basket good. LeBron's now got his first points of the game.
That's how you exploit that defense. Take the ball right to the basket.
Rondo kicks to Pierce. Outside for Rondo. Park down low that time, and he got the 3 second call.
You look at Doc Rivers, head coach of the Celtics, 6'4", strong point guard in his playing days, drafted out of Marquette. It was the first pick in the second round by the Atlanta Hawks, and still holds the franchise record for assists.
Now here's Wade. Still looking to get on the scoreboard. Shot's good.
I tell you what, he can be an offensive force when he's on top of his game, guys, and he usually is on top of his game.
Rondo with it. And it's Wade with the rebound.
And, you know, getting back to the playing career of Doc Rivers, guys, 13 seasons, an all-star in 1988. Never won a title, but, of course, he remedied that, coaching the Celtics in the championship back in 2008.
And it's the Heat with the ball. Rajon Rondo missing his last shot.
Carving him up inside there, Kevin. I mean, the defense has been vulnerable in there.
Yeah, that's three straight field goals in the paint area. That's really good offense.
Now here's Rondo. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Atlanta.
And Kevin, his passing is what drew me away. I mean, to see him orchestrate their offense so impeccably, that was a sight to behold.
Well, that's a solidly executed pick play. I mean, it paid dividends with that nice dunk.
Exactly the result they were looking for.
Yeah, it worked so well. I mean, he got set and did not shuffle his feet. Really well done there offensively.
And Miami has possession following the bucket by the Celtics. And that one's good. Harrington's got six.
That's all the space he needs, guys. He'll make you pay every time if you give him that shot.
You know, throughout the history of the NBA, the Celtics have been such a constant presence in the postseason that it's hard to imagine the playoffs without seeing the green. Every year the players change, but the Celtics' mystique is always in it, and that team is always hanging around.
Now here's Pierce. Second chance effort. Bass's shot. Good. He has seven.
Real persistence on his part. Stayed with the play and cashed in with the second chance points.
Oh, and the jam pie wave. What a play.
He has so much confidence, guys. What a finish.
That was a great angle we just saw, courtesy of Sprite. Celtics trail by five. It's really the mark of a great franchise. Boston expects great things from the Celtics each year, and more often than not, Steve, they deliver.
Yeah, you don't get all those banners that they have in that building without executing in the postseason. That's what this Celtics team has done the last few years. They play together, they play hard, they defend, and they're at their best when their best is needed.
Here's Clutch. He's covered by Rondo. Passes it to Wade. Rebound, Boston. This is the second time they've matched up against Miami.
And guys, had their free throw shooting been anywhere near up to par, I think it would have changed everything in that game.
No doubt about it. I mean, there is a carryover effect when you're not having success at the line. It infiltrates other parts of your game.
Well, Heat leading by five. And the defense didn't have position. They whistle a blocking foul, and he'll go to the line.
Dwayne Wade's one of the most versatile scorers in the NBA. We know that. I mean, his ability to score off the bounce, post up, get to the free throw line, score in transition. He's just so strong, and then he adds that great footwork to go along with it. Impossible to stop completely, that's for sure.
Looking at who's out there now for the Celtics. Melo comes in for Kevin Garnett. And it's Green in for Paul Pierce. Now, here's Bradley. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Hawks in Atlanta. And there's the foul. It's on Clutch. That is his first foul of the game. And Wade, never considered really an elite shooter, but as a slasher, I think, arguably. Clark, he might be the best in the league at that.
Yeah, that's not even debatable. He clearly is one of the elite slashers, not only now, but in the history of the game. And he perhaps is one of the best bank shooters off the dribble that we've seen. His agility and ability to get past defenders. He's got an eel-like quality to him to add to that athleticism, which makes him unbelievable to watch when he's got it going. Boy, a fast start here. Their offense has been very impressive.
Yeah, they're making their own luck, Clark, really playing with a purpose offensively.
And Bradley gets it to go. Bradley's got his first 2 points.
That's an old-fashioned finish there, guys. Going to the finger roll to get the easy two.
Here's Clutch. It's stolen by Bradley. The drive by Rondo. Cannot hit. Wade with the defensive effort.
Yeah, trying to put a little mustard on the hot dog here. That was just convert the shot. Come on.
And he finishes nicely on the layup. Wade's got 8 points.
Boy, I love the way they've been attacking inside, Kevin.
All right, guys, they're getting a lot of points in.
There's 1:26 left in the first. Garnett dishes to Lee. Puts it up from 15. Can't hit. The Heat go the other way with it. Here's Cole. Right now averaging 5 points a game. Outside for Harrington. It's rebounded by Rondo.
And that's a shot he had to take.
For sure, it was a good decision, just poor execution.
56 seconds left in the first quarter. Pass to Green. Backing in. That'll be Boston as it goes out of bounds. Celtics retain possession. And here on the 2K leaderboard are the teams with the quickest hands in the league. The Heat in fifth.
This team is an elite defensive team. Why? Because they do a nice job moving their feet, positioning their body, and playing with active hands. And when you do that, you come up with steals, and they're one of the league's best in that category as a team. Kevin, let's check out how Miami stacked up in the league stats over the last month. Tops in scoring. First in assists, and they're also number one in shooting percentage. This is a team that prides itself on taking high-quality shots.
And the points that they're scoring per game that you talked about is really a result of great offensive execution. And this is a club that works well together. They get great looks, and they'll also score in transition.
Haslam, that's good.
They got the ball into the ideal position, and he didn't flub the finish that time, guys.
The dish now to Banks. Lee outside. Kicks to Rondo. Garnett, right side. Releases. Hands the shot with nobody near him. 20 seconds left in the first quarter. Here's Cole. He's covered by Rondo. And Cole kicks to Allen. Haslam, a screen on Green. Here's Clutch. And again, Miami with the triple. And that does it for the first quarter. Heat out front. They lead by 9. And we'll be back shortly for the start of the second quarter.
Come out and join the crowd. Watch your Heat live and in person. Always great to see Clutch doing what he does best.
And welcome back. It's been all one-sided so far through the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And let's quickly break down the game we've been seeing from the Heat, guys.
Well, the thing they tried to establish right away was the presence down low. You look at the points in the paint. I think that's been the difference.
Yeah, and I like the fact, Steve, that they're not settling for the outside shots. I mean, go in there and get what you want. Keep attacking the rim.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's the second quarter to play on the court right now for the Celtics. We've got Lee. Brandon Bass is out there with Green. And it's Rajon Rondo. And it's Melo in at the center, locking down the middle. And Doris Burke has a report for us from the sideline.
Hi, Kevin. Clutch in their last time out against the Pistons put on a show. He finished with 33 points and was a major factor in two other categories, on the glass and with his assists, guys. Just numbers that really jump out at you in a box score.
And Doris, that really was a phenomenal performance.
You know what, Kevin? Anytime you bring it like that, you raise the bar on yourself. The key is to not get too hyped on past performances. Today, focus on this game right here, right now.
Yeah, but he's going to have a hard time forgetting that one because that was one of the best performances you'll ever see.
Here's Clutch. He picked up 33 points in their last win against Detroit.
I thought his rebounding was impressive as well, guys. He made some big boards, really helped out on the glass, helped his team out big time. Well, when you look at head coach Eric Spoelstra, a lot of pressure on him early on when the Heat went out and acquired the big three. And for a young head coach, there were a lot of questions about whether he'd be able to get them where they needed to go and command their respect.
And Jared Sullinger picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Some changes for Boston. Brandon Bass is checked in for Sullinger. And it's Lee in for Avery Bradley. And Miami with a change here, too. Ray Allen, he's checked in for Rashard Lewis. Wade, the second chance bucket is good.
He's been so solid. You've got to keep him out there on the floor, really doing a nice job for the offense.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time getting the lid off the basket so far.
Out to Lee. He feeds it to Rondo. drive to shoot. And Bass kicks to Rondo. Over LeBron. Again, the miss by the Celtics. You know, you talked about the pressure for Eric Spoelstra, the head coach. You know, there were signs that relationship with LeBron James was only probably so-so. But maybe, you know, as things kind of iron themselves out, they seem to be in a better place.
Well, there was so much pressure on the organization that I think everybody was on edge. And now that the...
Oh! Hammer time! Wow. Hammer time!
Ammonia strong finish right there, partner.
Terry against Miller. Terry, the pass to Wilcox. And that's the devastating one-handed jam.
Pretty significant lapse there on the defensive end, guys.
Yeah, those are the ones. You just can't allow that.
No, if you're giving up dunks and layups defensively, you're in huge trouble. And I think Jason Terry, guys, is one of the best six men in the league. He provides that instant offense off the bench. Sweet shooting stroke, can shoot it from deep. And, you know, if you look at him, he loves to go right. That's his sweet spot. One dribble right, pull up, he's automatic.
And the shot is good from Garnett.
Soft defense right there. Way too soft.
The Heat leading by eight. 1:36 left in the first half. Chalmers dishes to Haslam. From down in the low post, it goes. Haslam's got eight. I remember when Jason Terry started out with the Atlanta Hawks, the star player, putting up great numbers, but not a lot of wins.
And that, to me, a lot of times, Kevin, is a function of the environment you're in and the other players. This is not tennis or track and field or golf. You need other good players around you to win in the NBA. And where Dallas has that and have been perennial contenders, Terry has found a way to make major contributions. So I think he learned from his experience in Atlanta that you don't take being on a winning team for granted.
Sellinger's checked in for Boston. Dueling comes in for Rajon Rondo. And Miami with a change here, too. Rashard Lewis, he's checked in for Mike Miller. Garnett kicks to Dueling. Nice ball movement by Boston. In low to Garnett. That's good. Garnett's got 8 points. The Heat leading by six. Here's Clutch. Outside for Harrington. For the three. Harrington can't get that one to fall.
Well, it looks like he's cooled down a bit after hitting those two in the first quarter.
And stolen by Chalmers. Pushing it up. 7 second difference, shot and game clock. With the teardrop, and he makes good on the layup.
They're really making a point of taking it inside and scoring from close range.
Well, you have to give some of the credit, or actually the blame, I should say, to the defense. They are not doing anything in the paint area.
And here's Dula. On the wing, Jason Terry. Fires the three. Offensive rebound. Here's Bradley, puts the lead pass in front of him. Here's Garnett, and he beat the buzzer, but it's no good. So we've reached the end of the first half of play. Heat lead by eight.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
And welcome to halftime, everyone. Great one underway in Boston. The Heat taking care of business. A dramatic advantage in the paint. They're getting right in close and converting the kind of buckets they want. A big first half for Dwayne Wade. He has 17 points, and in addition to that, he's been a factor on the glass as well. Couple of helpers, too. And slugging it out so far, the Boston Celtics. They've looked to their bench for scoring, and it's paying big dividends. There's been some great work by Brandon Bass in this one. He has 12 points and is always looking to go to work on the boards. Thanks so much for spending halftime with me. Now let's head on back out to Kevin and the gang.
All right, the second half beginning in just a moment.
Nice numbers from D. Wade. He's got 17 points and 3 dimes. He's getting it done, making plays by setting up his teammates and grabbing some nice boards, too.
Yeah, he's doing all those little things that are so important.
For Miami, look at who they've got out there. Clutch in at shooting guard. LeBron James is out there with Al Harrington. And there's Haslam. And it's Wade in at the one.
And Kevin, he's really solidified his role as the closer on this team. You know, Miami struggled to figure out whether they'd go to LeBron or Bosh or Wade at first. I think Wade has become the guy.
Well, I tell you what, it's nice to have two guys that are capable of closing, Steve. And I agree with you, though. His aggressiveness and confidence probably give him a slight edge in closing over LeBron. You can play great defense on him, but he still typically finds a way to get the shot he wants.
Attacking the paint again and again.
You know, they're getting whatever they want. I mean, 8 straight points coming inside.
Pierce with it. He's picked up by LeBron.
That's going to be important for this team to fight over the top of screens defensively.
Yeah, you got to tag him and stay right close to him because with his touch, he doesn't need much space to get his shot off.
And it goes. That's good. And while we're thinking about him, did you guys catch his comments at the press conference after their last game?
He's clearly a big picture guy. I mean, it isn't really what he's done, but what the team has done. It's all about wins with this kid, and you have to respect that.
He's a competitor, no doubt about that. I mean, he doesn't go out and try to make friends or make highlights. He just comes in with one agenda, and that's just to win the basketball game every night.
Here's Clutch. He's covered by Rondo. Shot clock at 6. That drops. 8 points for LeBron.
And that's 4 straight from the field, guys. Off to a quick start this third quarter.
Rondo kicks to Bradley. The feed to Pierce. Back to Bradley. Lets it go from the wing. And it's Miami with the rebound. Harrington's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. They'll be off to Brooklyn for a meeting with the Nets after this one. That'll be the 2nd on the road in the midst of this long 4-game road stand.
Well, you know, the fans out in Brooklyn desperately hoping for their team to win that one.
Rondo against Wade. Now here's Rondo. Right now averaging 11 points a game. And Garnett misses.
And the offense continues to struggle. Just 1 make in their 5 attempts.
Here's Clutch. He dishes it to Harrington. From the arc. And Boston with the rebound. Garnett's got 4 rebounds in this game. Haslam, that's good.
Well, they keep going right back to the paint. And who can blame them? I mean, they're getting it done in there.
Yeah, 3 of their last 5 buckets, guys, have come from inside the lane area. So I'd expect them to continue to go inside right at the defense.
On defense, the Heat. They've only allowed 2 points so far here in the second half. Rondo passes to Brandon. Here's Bass. Down goes the slam.
Boy, that's hard-nosed sandpaper basketball right there. A lot of little friction in there, partner.
Oh, I love the way you described that. Was it ever? Nobody was going to get to the rim but him.
Oh, man, with the violent putback to finish it off.
Here's Clutch. He's got 14. The kick out to LeBron. 5 on the clock. Sinks that one from the post. LeBron's now got 10 points.
Very few players have his explosiveness. I mean, man, can he ever fly to get to that rim?
Rondo off the pick from Bass. Rondo dishes to Bass. It's stolen by Wade. And here's the fast break. LeBron leading the way. Shoots over Bradley. Here's Haslam. Goes up strong with 1 hand and flushes it down.
Step aside, step aside. We've got the big fella coming through.
That is a powerful brand of basketball right there.
Man, an amazing putback. You just love the effort from this guy.
Looking to get it going. Bradley can't get it to go.
You know, it might not be the biggest margin, but don't take what they've done on the boards for granted. I mean, it's been a strong area for them in this game.
Well, you know, Clark, I mean, it all adds up. You do a little bit better job here, a little better job there, and you look up, it's a big difference on the scoreboard. He slipped into quite a funk here, Clark.
I think that's a good word to describe it. I mean, the basket is looking awfully small to him at the moment.
That's good.
Now they've got to offer more resistance inside. Just too many easy buckets in the paint.
Yeah, Steven, that's the top priority for any defense. You got to protect the paint.
You know, it's interesting. Rajon Rondo, an all-star player, acknowledged as one of the premier point guards in the game, and yet, seems like year after year, we hear his name in trade rumors. And some of that may be because he's butted heads with Doc Rivers at times, but it also may be because he's so valuable. He's such a dominant player, he would bring back an awful lot in return.
And that one's good. And that's 23 points for Wade.
Well, he's smart. He's getting good shots, and he's knocking them down.
Outside, Rondo feeds it to Garnett. To the inside, Bass, and he converts the layup. Bass has got 16 points. And the trade rumors for Rondo, some of the rumors in Boston were that he was strong-willed, sometimes kind of a loner. He was tough to coach him, on and on and on. And perhaps it was him being with such great players, and he wanted to just take his time as he was establishing himself, Park, on that team. I mean, there could be a lot of reasons there.
Exactly. I agree. And not being close enough to the situation, I'm not going to get involved in conjecture there. He does have a strong personality. He's an extremely bright basketball player, and good players sometimes are challenging to coach. But I think at the end of the day, you want to give any young player a chance to develop and mature. And with the talent Rondo has, I think you've got to give him room to continue to grow.
Here's Clutch, guarded by Bradley. There's the pick. It's LeBron with the drive. And there's another one for the Heat.
Well, he did a nice job losing his man on a good pick and then just buried the jumper. That is basketball 101 right there, Kevin.
Well, there have been a few small forwards helping their teams in all sorts of ways lately. Like this group, leading the position in rebounding the last 10 games. Fourth, LeBron James.
You know, the work they do on the boards is such a big part of all of these players' games. They play much bigger than the grand majority of small forwards in this league.
And I think it's an area that they all take pride in, Steve. They know they can score. That's expected of their position, but where you separate...
Bass kicks to Bradley. He kicks it to Rondo. Lobs it up there. Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. Bradley against Chalmers. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
And, you know, guys, Mario Chalmers has been a good fit in Miami as that point guard because he doesn't need the ball in his hands all the time. LeBron and Wade can handle it. He can spot up and take threes. And then at the other end of the floor, he's a scrappy defender as well.
The Celtics making a switch here. Garnett's checked in. Shot on the wing. Rebound by the Heat.
And no defender was around him to influence that shot. It didn't hurt them there, but, you know, they can't make that mistake twice.
Haslam, guarded by Garnett, off the pick. Haslam can't get it to go.
And, you know, you look at a guy like Mario Chalmers. I mean, some of his weaknesses as a player are minimized playing for the Heat. He's not a great finisher or an elite playmaker, but, again, he can leave that to LeBron and D-Wade to create and play off of those guys. It really helps his game.
And good on the basket. Book it. 15 points for Paul Pierce.
Now, they may have to climb on his back to get back into this game.
This is the Chalmers. There's Clutch, guarded by Bradley. Crashes it down.
He power surged that one down. Wow.
Yeah, good term to use. One of the game's top dunkers for sure.
Oh, no question. And he loves to attack the rim, doesn't he?
Outside Rondo. He passes to Brent. Looking to get back on track here. And that one's good. Bradley's got 10 points in the game.
Boy, they are really getting chewed up inside here. I mean, that's 8 of the last 10 points they've given up inside, in the paint.
Yeah, and the paint should be sacred ground for a defense. I mean, you can't let anybody just trot in there and get an easy bucket.
Chalmers pass to Allen. And that comes off the assist by Mario Chalmers.
Well, Allen is the all-time leader in three-pointers made past Reggie Miller a couple of years ago. So, obviously, you have to worry about him out there. But what makes Allen so good is that he can also put the ball on the floor get into the paint and score at that mid-range area as well.
And he really has a fondness for those corners. I mean, you just can't help off of him. Too much of a threat from out there. You've got to stay connected to him.
Yeah, that was kind of clumsy looking. He was not...
The Heat shooting about 59% from the floor offensively. They've been running without a hitch. Rajon Rondo and Avery Bradley out there in the backcourt. Green is out there with Jared Sullinger. And it's Pierce in at the small forward. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. Here comes Rajon Rondo. The pass to Bradley. There's the screen. Back to Rondo.
Well, guys, you see all these great fans, and it reminds you that what sports are really all about is kind of a community spirit, pride in the community and the team itself. And, you know, whether you're watching the pros or college ball or high school or just standing around the water cooler, I mean, sports and talking about sports can provide that common bond and a way to make friendships and overcome social barriers.
Fourth quarter of basketball. We're about a minute into it. Sullinger with a screen for Pierce. Green left side. Over Haslam. Green, no luck. Well, Steve, you make a great point about the universality of sports. Passionate sports fans from the humblest of settings. Right, Clark, you know this, to the White House. You had a chance to interview President Barack Obama during the NCAA tournament.
You know, it was actually my second time to be in the company of the president on the White House basketball court. And what a treat and pleasure that was to spend time with our president talking about a shared passion and bond with the game of basketball. I'm a blessed man to have been able to experience that not just once, but twice.
Sullinger dishes to Bradley. Shot from free throw range. Another shot. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there. And a moment to check out Miami and who they've got coming up. So it's off to Brooklyn after this game as they have the Nets to look forward to. That'll be game two of four straight on the road. The first one falls.
Jared Sullinger is a big...
Just under 2.5 minutes gone here in the final quarter. Garnett. Back to Rondo. Passes it to Pierce. Over Battier. There's Pierce. That's good on the assist by Rondo. And that's now 17 points for Paul Pierce. And Steve, you mentioned Jared Sullinger's lack of explosiveness. But you look at the success, say, of Kevin Love in the NBA. Reminds you not to overlook guys just because of it.
Yeah, you know what? Everybody is enamored with the athleticism of today's players, and I am too, heck. It's enjoyable to watch, but there are a lot of good basketball players, present and past and future, that weren't explosive athletes. Sullinger is a skilled, hard-working, winning player, and he's going to be much the same in his long NBA career. This guy's going to be effective.
To the paint, and he pins it home with one hand.
Not stop. No way to stop that. I mean, there's nothing you can do when he's coming at him like that.
Well, that's right, Clark. Steve, he is a dangerous, dangerous player.
Yeah, especially when he gets to that launching pad right there in the lane. I mean, pretty one-handed finish. That was nice.
The shot by Terry. Basket is good. The assist from Rondo. The Heat leading by 23. Here's Clutch.
You know, the NBA is always trying to get games sped up in the final minutes, but it's a tough one because there's so many timeouts. So one of the things the league did in terms of rule changes is they did a two-horn buzz to get timeouts ending on time. They basically give teams an advance warning and then a final horn.
The dish to Cole. Here's Clutch. And the rebound goes to Jason Terry. And it's Rondo penetrating. Cashes in off the spry spin to the middle. Well, and as the two-horn rule you mentioned, Steve, it has seemed to have an effect in how the game is sped up.
And it should. I mean, I like that, Kevin, because there are a lot of stoppages these days. You know, plenty of timeouts late in games. We have instant replay as well. So anything that keeps the game moving and keeps the momentum going forward is, I think, a good thing.
You know, you look at how this has played out so far, and they've really had a big advantage inside.
Now they're getting higher percentage shots in the lane, and they're getting a bounce here or there, but I think they're playing pretty well down there.
Back to Green from outside the arc, and the shot is good. Green's got 7 points for the quarter.
You cannot back that far off of a guy. I mean, I don't care who he is. These guys are pros. They all can shoot. D up.
Looking at who's out there now for the Celtics. Brandon Bass is checked in for Green. And it's Avery Bradley in for Jason Terry. And a new group in for the Heat. Udonis Haslem, he's checked in for Battier. Harrington comes in for James Jones. LeBron, he's checked in for Mike Miller. And Dwayne Wade is subbed in for Norris Cole. Garnett outside.
You know, it's kind of fun to look at some of the studies that come out of the sabermetrics community, these numbers crunchers. They've got their place. One of the recent ones studied player types and positions. One finding was that versatile small forwards who can shoot the three-pointer are tremendously valuable as far as wins added to the total.
And it's off from three-point range. Celtics trail by 18. And it's Rondo penetrating. Al Harrington grabs the board. Harrington's got 6 rebounds in the game. Clark has talked about that study and, you know, the value of the versatile three-point shooting small forward, for instance. You know, there are not a lot of those, Steve, and that's kind of interesting.
Yeah, it's changed the game, really, Kevin, when you think about it. Guys like Paul Pierce, Kevin Durant, Rudy Gay, you know, Gallinari. Because one thing coaches are doing is moving those three men and playing them as small fours. So you put those guys at the power forward spot, you're shooting threes out there, it just really opens up the floor and it changes the game dramatically.
Came hard off that pick and finished strong.
Well, I tell you what, it was the good pick that was set that turned him loose.
And once he got around it, Steve, it was smooth sailing right to the hole.
Well, because of the pick, he had plenty of room. That's why he was able to power down that slam.
Here's clutch. Open look. Good. He hits the jump shot. Clutch has got 24 points.
Wow, has he caught fire this quarter, shooting the ball with tremendous confidence.
Pierce, covered by LeBron. Poked loose. Rondo kicks to Pierce. It's good, coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. 19 points for Paul Pierce. The Heat leading by 18. Here's clutch. Pass to LeBron. Now here's Pierce. Defense is right there.
It's been a nice game for Pierce. 19 points and 5 assists.
He's been very efficient offensively, and defensively, he's been disruptive out there.
And to me, that's a terrific combination, Steve, the kind that wins you a lot of ball games.
Well, Paul Pierce has become one of the all-time greats in Celtic history, second all-time in points and steals, top 10 in pretty much every other stat. And, of course, the Finals MVP in 2008, probably his proudest moment as a Celtic.
Here's clutch, guarded by Bradley. They get the rebound. Haslem, and the layup is good. Haslem's got 14 points now in the second half.
And that's why you love this guy. I mean, tremendous work on the offensive boards. He just gets you second-chance points.
And what a great career for Paul Pierce. You'd like to see him be able to retire as a Boston Celtic, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I certainly would, Kevin. I've always wanted to see outstanding players spend their entire careers with one team. It doesn't happen. The landscape is different now for a number of reasons. Players move on. But when it can happen, it's really special. And Paul would certainly fall into that special category. He's a Hall of Famer, and if he could do it all in one uniform, that would even make it sweeter.
Celtics trail by 18. Kicks to Bass. He feeds it to Bradley. Outside Rondo. the feed to Garnett. Back to Rondo. Six to shoot. From beyond the arc, clutch corrals the miss inside.
Well, I tell you what, guys, his struggles from the field have definitely taken their toll on the team today.
And the shot is good. Clutch has got 10 points now just in this quarter.
Well, they haven't had to ask him to do too much, but he's doing whatever's needed out there.
Bradley passes to Garnett. He dishes it to Rondo. Back to Garnett. And it's good, coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. 16 points for Garnett. The Heat leading by 18. LeBron James on the wing. From about 16, again the Heat, good for two.
Man, offensive execution has been the story here, just playing beautiful basketball.
And guys, you can see it in their advantage in field goal percentage. I mean, you get high quality shots, you're usually going to shoot well. They're playing outstanding basketball.
And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
They've gotten some good second chances here in the second half, and that kind of extra effort will go a long way into cutting into this deficit.
And so Bass nails both of them. The Heat shooting impressively throughout at 62%. The drive by LeBron leads him in there. Wade, and he uses both hands to jam it in.
Just cruising to the finish line.
Yeah, and barring something catastrophic happening, it looks like they'll go home with a nice victory here.
Feeds it to Bradley. Corner shot. It's hauled in by the Heat. Harrington's got rebound number 7 for him tonight.
He's laboring out there right now, guys. The shot has not been falling for him this quarter.
And LeBron James gets it to go.
Nice offensive play there, and this one's pretty much in the books, guys.
Yeah, I agree. You know what? It was a very good showing from them to come away with the win. I was very impressed.
And a whole new group out on the floor for the Celtics. He kicks it to Terry. Easy shot, gets it to go. Terry's got 6 points in the quarter.
And the Jet, as he's known, is a great shooter, both from mid-range and long-range, can step out well behind that three-point line and knock down the shot. But really what he wants to do is put the ball on the floor a couple times, create the angle, and then rise up over the top and make that mid-range shot.
And Steve, whether starting or coming off the bench, JT is always ready to step into the big moment and knock down the big shot.
That'll be Boston as it goes out of bounds. Celtics retain possession. Shane Battier is checked in for the Heat. Lewis comes in for LeBron. Green left side. Dishes it to Melo. He passes to Dewing. Just 5 on the clock. Here's Terry. And it's Terry again missing.
Boy, they were ready for him right there. I mean, totally collapsed the defense on him.
Here's Clutch. Lets it go from deep. The rebound by Jeff Green. 40 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Dueling dishes to Wilcox. And that's going to be a travel.
Boy, I'm not quite sure what he was thinking there.
That's not going to help, Steve.
Miami's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Here's Clutch. This one for 3. And the rebound goes to Jason Terry. The Celtics shooting very well right now, 52% in this fourth quarter. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. It's hauled in by the Heat.
Well, at least he had the presence of mind to change his shot when the defense got on him. You've got to improvise sometimes.
Here's Clutch, guarded by Green. Takes the 13-footer. It's off. And so Miami takes this one by a big margin. They put on a show tonight, thoroughly controlling each end of the floor.
Hey, what more can you ask?
That'll do it for now. For Doris Burke, Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and the rest of the 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for joining us.
It has just been announced that you have been named the Conference Player of the Week for the past week. This is the first time you've received this award. Can we expect more of this from you in the future?
I'm definitely going to do my best to win Player of the Week every week, you know? I definitely couldn't have done it without help from my teammates, though, the coaches, and of course, the fans. Winning this award isn't what I work hard for all summer long, but it's certainly a great thing to get along the way towards the real prize.